The New Zealand Rural English Dialect.
New Zealand English Dialect, Rural Waikato.
The Universal Declaration of Human Rights.
All human beings are born free and equal in dignity and rights. They are endowed with the reason and conscience and should act towards one another in a spirit of brotherhood.
Numbers.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Greetings and phrases.
Hello. Kia ora. Good morning. Good afternoon. Good evening. Good night. Bye. Goodbye. Yeah. Nah. Maybe. Okay. Thank you. You're welcome. Excuse me. I'm sorry.
Vocabulary.
Cheers. Ta. All goods. Sweet as. Kumara. Jandals. Dairy. Batch. Kiwi. Togs. Tramp. Whānau. Chili bin. Footpath. Smoko. The Wops.
Pronunciation.
Air. All. Apple. About. Bath. Better. Body. Book. Brother. Butter. Car. Cat. Cheese. Dark. Day. Daughter. Dog. Earth. Example. Face. Family. Father. Fire. Friend. Full. Garage. Good. House. Idea. Important. Jewelry. Juice. Kitchen. Knowledge. Laugh. Light. Like. Mate. Milk. Mother. Moon. Mountain. Mouth. Name. Natural. New. Night. Ocean. Oil. Old. Orange. Organization. Paper. Place. Radio. Rare. School. Sister. Sun. Star. Station. Sun. Things. Thunder. Uniform. Video. Village. Water. Young. Zed.
The wren.
The wren. The wren used to have his nest in the car shed. Once the old ones had both flown out, they had wanted to get something to eat for their young and had left the little ones all alone. After a while, Father Wren returns home. "What's happened here?" he says. "Who harmed you, children? You were all terrified." "Oh, Dad," they say. "Some big boogeyman came by just now. He looked so fierce and horrible. He stared into our nest with his big eyes. That scared us heaps." "I see," Father Wren says. "Where did he go?" "Well," they say, "he went down that way." "Wait," Father Wren says. "I'll be after him. Don't you worry now, children, I'll get him." Thereupon, he flies after him. When he comes around the bend, it is the lion who is walking along there. But the wren is not afraid. He alights on the lion's back and starts scolding him. "What business do you have coming to my house," he says, "and terrifying my children?" The lion pays no attention to it and keeps walking. That makes a little loud mouth berate him even more fiercely. "You have no business being there, I tell you, and if you come back," he says, "well then you'll see. I don't really want to do it," he says, and finally lifts one of his legs. "But I'd break your back with my leg in a second." Thereupon he flies back to his nest. "There you go, children," he says. "I've taught that one a lesson. He won't be back."